Hi friends, in this video I am going to say about a problem on design of a spar gear. The problem is as follows. Design a pair of spar gear to transmit 20 kW of power at 900 rpm of the pinion. The pinion is made up of cast steel having allowable stress of 190 MPa. The gear is made up of cast steel having allowable stress of 100 MPa. Rotates at 144 rpm. The number of teeth on the pinion is 16. The teeth are 20 degree involute profile and the ratio of space width to the module is 10. So take C is equals to 550 Newton per mm for a dynamic load and check for the wear to determine the oddness of the gears. So coming to the solution, so let us note down the given data. So the power is given, so 20 kilowatts. N1 is given, that is the speed at pinion, N1 is equal to 900 rpm. Allowable stress of pinion is given, that is sigma naught 1 is equal to 190 MPa. Sigma naught 2 is given, that is 100 MPa, allowable stress of gear. RPM of gear is given as 144 rpm. Teeth on the pinion is given as 16, so I want to take as 16. Alpha, that is the profile. Tooth profile is nothing but 20 degree full depth involute. And the base ratio they are given, the face width and the ratio of the module is 10. So I am going to take as face width is equal to 10 into module. And C value is given, which is a constant, which you are going to take in the dynamic load as 550 Newton per mm. So let us start the problem with the velocity ratio. The equation you can get as I is equals to N1 by N2, that will be equals to D2 by D1, so that will be equals to Z2 by Z1. You can get this in the data and book, equation number 23.1. So I am going to take I is equals to N1 by N2, so both the values are given. So I will be equals to 6.25, that is the ratio, velocity ratio. So we also know that Z2 by Z1 is equals to I. So Z2 is equals to I into Z1. So 6.25 into 16 is going to get us 100 teeth. So Lewis form factor for a 20 degree involute profile you can get from the data and book, equation number 23.116. So I want to take Lewis form factor, y is equals to 0.154 minus 0.9120 by z. So I want to calculate for both y1 and y2, that is pinion and the gear. So z1 you already know, that is 16, I'm going to substitute, I'm going to get as 0.097. y2 I'm going to substitute, that is z2, as 100 teeth I'm going to get as 0.144488. So let us go for the step 1 to find the weaker member. So I want to take the table, that is pinion and the gear. So second column will be the sigma, that is allowable stress, y, that is the Lewis form factor, and the third column, fourth column will be summation of allowable stress into Lewis form factor. So pinion allowable stress is 190, which is given in the problem. So I calculated the Lewis form factor as 0.097, summation will be 18.43. For a gear, it will be 100.14488. So I want to get as 14.48. So in this comparing, this is the lowest value. So I want to consider gear as a weaker member. So coming on to the step 2, the design. The design should be based on the weaker member. So the design should be based on the gear. So I want to consider the step 2 design. That is, the first will be the tangential tooth load. That is Buckingham equation. The equation will be Ft is equals to 9500 and 550 into N, Cs, N into R. So where N is the speed, R is the radius. So since the design is based on the gear, I am going to consider this as N2 and R2. Here I am going to substitute 1000 over here just to make the R, which is in mm, and I am going to put directly in mm. So I am going to go for the conversion as 1000 at the top. For a service factor, CS is a service factor that has to be considered. If the condition is not given, I want to assume as medium shock, 8 to 10 hours of duty per a day. So from the table number 23.13, I can get CS, that is service factor as 1.5. So coming on to the R, so D2 by 2, so D2 is not given, so I want to take as M into Z2. So Z2 is the number of T, so I want to substitute that, I want to get as 50 M. So once I want to substitute these values, so I want to get Ft is equals to 9550 into 1000 into 20 into 1.5, 144, that is the speed of the gear, 50 m, that is your radius. So I want to get that one as 39791.667 by m newtons. The second step in this design will be tangential tooth load. using the Lewis equation. So Ft is equals to sigma naught 2, that is the equation we're going to take is 23.93 sigma naught B P Y into KV. Since your design is based on the gear, I'm going to take as 2 sigma naught 2 and Y2. So P, that is the circular pitch, I'm going to take as pi into M. B I'm going to assume as 10 into M, which is given in the question now. KV I'm going to keep as it is, that is the velocity factor. So I'm going to get this values as 455.15 m square into kV. So I'm going to equate this equation and this equation. So I'm going to get, equating this to, I'm going to get as m cube kV is equals to 87.425. Just remember this equation, because based on this I'm going to find out the module. So I'm going to find out mean pitch velocity, that is Vm is equals to pi D2 N2 by 60,000. So values I'm going to substitute. So D2 is unknown, so I'm going to substitute that as M into Z2. So I'm going to substitute the values, I'm going to get that as 0.753 m. To find KV, use a trial and error method I'm going to use. So trial 1, I'm going to assume this as M is equals to 4 mm. This I can assume by the table 23.3, where the values which are out of the bracket will be considered the standard value, which are inside the bracket are non-standard values. So I want to consider 4 mm as the module first. So I'm going to substitute the module in this equation. So I'm going to get that as 3.012 meter per second. So there are a condition, that is Vm is less than 7.5, Vm is less than 12.5. Based on that, the velocity factor ratios will be varying. So for this, the velocity is less than 7.5. So the equation I'm going to take, that is the equation number 23.134a. So KV is equals to 3 divided by 3 plus 3.02. So I'm going to assume that one as 0.0499. So equating that in the equation, previous equation, I'm going to get as 39.936, which is less than 87.425. So it is not suitable. So I'm going to take the next one, trial number 2, that is M is equals to 5. So Vm is equals to 0.753 into 5. So I'm going to get as 3.765 meter per second, which is also less than 7.5 meter per second. So I'm going to take KV. So KV is equals to 3 by 3 plus Vm, that is nothing but the equation number 23.134a. So I'm going to get as 0.557. So that will be equated in the equation of this. So I'm going to get that one as 5 cube into, substituting the values, I'm going to get as 55.43. which is less than 87.425. So it is not suitable. So I'll go for the trial 3. So when I go for the trial 3, so I'm going to assume that as 6 mm as a module. So Vm is equals to 0.753 into m. So Vm I'm going to get as 4.518. So which is less than 7.5. So I'm going to consider the velocity factor as KV is equals to 3 by 3 plus Vm. And I'm going to substitute that, I'm going to get as 0.419. When I'm going to substitute this value along with the module, I'm going to get the value as 90.504, which is greater than 87.425. So hence it is suitable for us, our design. So I'm going to assume module M is equals to 6 mm. The next step is to check for the stresses, whether what are the values you assume, that is the module is safe or not. So first you have to find out allowable stress, which is nothing but sigma naught 2 into KV. So sigma allowable will be equals to 100, into which you got over here, that is 0.419. So that I want to substitute, I want to get as 41.9 megapascals. So sigma induced, I have to find what is the induced stress on the gear. For that I want to consider the Ft divided by B Y2 into P. So I want to substitute the values of this. So I want to get value as 40.47 megapascals. In this Ft, you're going to take the first equation, that is 39.39791.667 divided by M. So M you can substitute as 6. So I'm going to get value as 40.47 megapascals. From this you can see that, so this 41.9, that is allowable stress, is greater than the induced stress. So our design is safe. So third step in this design will be on the dimensioning of the gear. So dimensioning you can get from the table number 23.1. So module what you have selected is 6 mm, so that is your design. So for a 20 degree inverted profile, the addendum HA will be 1 module, so that will be 6. Dedendum will be HF, that is 1.25 module. So 1.25 into 6, 7.5 I'm going to get. Working depth, that is H dash, so 2 into module, so I'm going to get as 12. Total depth H is equals to 2.25 m, so I'm going to get that as 13.5 mm. Tooth thickness S is equals to 5 by 2 into m, so I'm going to get as 9.42. Pitch diameter of pinion, so Z1 into M 96. Pitch diameter of the gear, it will be 600 mm. And center distance A is equals to M by 2 into Z1 plus Z2. So I'm going to get as 348 mm. Tangential load, so I'm going to get as 6631.94 N. And VM, that is mean velocity, is 4.518 m/s. So face weight will be equals to 60. Pitch will be equals to 9.42 m. The step 4 will be checking. So here we're going to check the loads. That is, one is the dynamic load and the wear load. So for this dynamic load, the formula is Buckingham. This equation you're going to take, that is FD is equals to FT plus 21 VM into FT plus BC. So 21 VM plus root of FT plus BC. In this, E value is already given in the equation. So I'm going to substitute the values of this. So FT is this value, VM is this value, and B value are going to take as 60 mm. So I'm going to substitute all the values in the equation. So I'm going to get that value as 19,423.65 N. So now dynamic load is 19,423.65 N. The wear load, Fw is equals to D1BQK. So that is the equation number 23.160. So here Q will be given as 2Z2 divided by Z1 plus Z2. So I want to substitute the values of the teeth. 100 plus divided by 16 plus 100. I want to get as 1.724. For a safer design, Fw should be always greater or equal to the dynamic load. So I want to substitute the equation. D1BQK of Fw should be greater than 19,423.65. That is the value of Fd. So I'm going to substitute D1 value, B value, Q value. I'm going to keep K as it is. So when I'm going to find out the values, I'm going to get that K should be greater or equal to 1.956 N/mm². So if you go for the table 23.37B, so we're going to have columns. So in that column, you have to select alpha as 20 degree full depth involute and K should be more than 1.956. So based on this, I'm going to get the surface hardness number for pinion as 400. The surface hardness of gear will be equals to 350. So this is the design of the gear.